Good evening and welcome to Let's Play Fallout 4. Super excited about this game. I've played Fallout 3, and that's really the only game that I've played. That was my first, as I'm sure for many, my first game in the Fallout series. I know lots of people played 1 and 2, but for a bunch of us, that was the one, and it was just incredible, so I'm expecting big things out of this. This is a blind playthrough, and I know you're thinking, well, it has the option for her to continue. My husband has been playing a whole lot of this as well, and we use the same Steam account, so let me get in here. New game. Game? There we go. I know, I'm impatient. Alright, I'm not really sure what to expect out of this. I'm kind of hoping Three Dog will be back, because I actually really love Three Dog from Fallout 3.
War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction.
Ooh.
Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers.
Look at that behemoth.
But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
All right, so that's a pretty awesome intro. Oh, what do we got here?
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Cool. Okay, well, I'm going to play a female, being one myself.
My turn, big guy.
Oh. Look around some. I'm sure we have all kinds of options here. These Bethesda games generally do. Okay, what do we got? Oh, presets. Ooh, I kind of like this hair. Is that the one I want to... All right, we'll tinker a little bit. I don't want to take too long on figuring out the face. I don't know. I kind of like the default. This hair, though. All right, what else can we do? Okay. Highlight an area to scope. Oh my gosh. Eyes, top eyelids. Oh, this is, there's too many options. There's so much stuff we can mess around with. So what can we do? We can, okay, scale them. Up, down, or no, that's like in, out. Oh my gosh, oh, that's kind of creepy. Yeah, sure, it's good.
Totally has your eyes.
Oh, color. Yeah, brown will do.
I think Sean has my eyes.
Type, what's that mean? Ooh, suspicious.
You do know you've got the most beautiful eyes I've ever seen.
Let's go suspicious eyes. I kind of like that. No, I mean, there's only slight differences,
yeah,
but the name appeals to me. All right, going back. What else? Do I really care about everything else?
You have such a cute chin.
Oh, this is all chin, huh? Okay, what about, yeah, mouth.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Okay, so we're on skin tone. We've got a whole range. Let's be a sun-kissed.
As beautiful as the day we met.
How do we change lips? Oh, I suppose it doesn't matter. Extras. Oh, makeup.
That looks nice.
Can I get, like, no lipstick? We could have some cool scars and stuff. Yeah, let's have a cool scar.
Every time I see that face, I fall in love with you all over again.
Where'd my scar go? Oh, there we go. Blemishes, huh? Oh, we can have dark eyes. A rough face. Lip color. We can be pimply. And we've got all kinds of options here. Markings. Oh, freckles. Alright, this'll do. Well, I guess body. Ooh. Nice mom pants she's got on. So thin. We can be a big girl. Muscular. Well, I'm assuming we're going to be out there, you know, beating on some enemies. And my plan is to do hand to hand because I enjoy beating my enemies to death. So we want to be, you know, a fairly strong kind of gal. Yeah, that'll do. Okay, I think we're done. Oh, I did want to see if I could change the hair color just a little bit. Where would that be? Face?
Yeah, I like that.
Hair. There we go. I like the light brown. Sure. Actually, I like maybe the chestnut a little better. It'll do.
I love it.
But we'll keep this style. I like that. All right, that's enough. Sure. Oh, I just saw Mr. Handy breeze by. Oh, how's it going, Nate?
I'm hurrying up, don't worry.
Okay, so... Way of the Future. Nice packaging.
The Braxo for all your cleaning needs. Another fine product of General Atomics International. Let Codsworth take care of it.
All right.
Good old US of A. We really need to get those vacation photos developed.
Hey, this is not looking at all post-apocalyptic. We're playing pre-apocalyptic? We're clearly not in a vault. Okay.
No need to get dressed twice. I'm so proud of him.
Anything in here? No.
Should get this signed next time we're at the park. Glove's a little big now, but Sean will grow into it.
Yeah, if he's just a baby, it's gonna be a while before he can use this trike either.
Teach him to ride this. He'll either be great at spelling or great at smashing blocks together. Think one day he's gonna learn how to drive.
Oh, the your special book.
Sean will grow up to be.
Oh, we don't read it this time. Hey there, Sean. Blast radius, eh? Oh, and Nate's a bowler. Or maybe we are. Maybe we're on the ladies' bowling league. Who knows? What do we got here? Ooh, Blamco mac and cheese.
Fancy lad snack cakes. Blamco mac and cheese. Expires in... never.
Only the best.
Ah, good morning, Mum.
Good morning, Codsworth. Why, thank you.
And today's newspaper just delivered.
Thanks, Codsworth.
Of course, Mum.
All right. Well, sure, let's have some coffee. Ooh, Ugnak.
Ugnak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
Quality reading. Ooh, sugar bombs.
100% daily value of sugar.
Yeah, that's the way to start the day. Oh, what's wrong, Sean? Ah, well, thanks, Codsworth. We were nervous about Codsworth? Codsworth is awesome.
Do I look nervous? I look nervous, don't I?
Oh, what do we got here?
More of the same.
Ooh.
It's a little early to be drinking.
All right. Oh, is this our car in our carport? Look at that beast. Our bread box. Always important.
How can someone so small drink so much?
Oh, I like this window into the fridge. What do we have? Call a repairman. Here's our grocery list. Get more sugar bombs and Nuka-Cola, because we need more sugar in our lives. Ooh, well.
Nuka-Cola. Ice cold. Looks like the milk got delivered. Saddle up Salisbury steak. Rated A+.
He's persistent. I'll give him that.
Who? Who's at the door?
Vault-Tec stock continues to rise as tensions
Let's enjoy some tunes. Ooh, a lot of them.
Late nights. It was worth it.
Who is it that we don't want to talk to?
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Ooh, a Vault-Tec rep. Why, Vault-Tec?
Vault-Tec? Remind me again.
Why, we're about you, ma'am, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will.
Uh-huh.
Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation.
Well.
You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's
okay.
A matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so urgent?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, ma'am, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. If you catch my meaning...
You got some inside info?
Now, I know you're a busy woman, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being, a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault.
Ooh, I don't even have to buy my way in or anything, eh?
111.
Okay, now normally, well, since we're pre-selected, I'd say, all right, let's do it. In general, I wouldn't even talk to a door-to-door salesman because, like most people, I hate solicitors. But since we have an idea about an apocalypse that is going to be coming from familiarity with the Fallout world, this sounds pretty great.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of... total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
All right. Sure.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid. Splendid. Now, let's see.
What you got? Oh, a name? Well. Hey. Name. There we go. Lavinia, of course. How do we... 21 points. Strength, how much we can carry, and damage of melee. So melee is going to be important, because I intend to melee. Let's go maybe 7. Perception. Affects accuracy in vets. We want a little bit there. Endurance, total health. Okay, so endurance is pretty important. Since we're doing melee, we're going to take probably a fair chunk of hits. Let's see. Charisma is probably not really that important, but I still want some points in it. Intelligence, that is going to be her. Okay, number of experience points earned. Yeah, that's pretty good. Agility, I don't think I care too much about that. Number of action points in vats. Okay. Luck, I'm not that concerned about. We'll leave a 2 in luck, and... Let's go kind of vaguely all out on the strength. Yeah, we're going to be crazy strong. Looks good.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just going to walk this over to the vault.
All right.
Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you, yeah. Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Oh, he's still sad.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection people seem to be so good at.
Yeah, babies need to be held by humans, not just robots. Oh, but here's our bathroom. Did I look at this? Yeah, this is where we started off. There wasn't really much to interact with there. Okay. Hey, Sean. All right. There you go. What a happy baby.
Behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time, anyway. Listen, after breakfast. I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
All right. Ooh, Halloween prep sounds fun too. But no, we can go to the park. That'll be good.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
What's the problem?
Blinding flashes, sounds of explosions.
Oh, is this it? Are we playing the apocalypse?
What did he say? Codsworth?
We do have coming in. That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Well, good thing we got a place in a vault.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Oh, okay. Hey, wait up, wait up.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills. If you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111.
Okay, he went that way, but can I go this way? What's over here? Oh, it's just a roundabout. Alright. Maybe I should stop messing around. Nice flamingos. Ooh, look at that car. What's up, guys?
Hey there.
This is just a drill, right?
Doing all right over here? Oh. All right. You guys okay here?
Excuse me.
God,
nah, none of them are talking to me. Let's just keep moving. Oh, good. We caught up with Nate and Sean.
That's absurd. I am
not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me.
Hey, hon.
Okay.
They're not letting this guy in? I'm in the program?
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant? Adult male? Adult female? Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Okay.
Good luck, sir.
Get to the vault!
And God help us all.
You two, follow me! Come on!
What's going on with all those people outside
the gate? We're doing everything we can!
Now it's crappy, Nate, but we really can't worry about that right now. If there's only limited space in the vault, well. Ooh, what's up here, though?
Ma'am, we need to send you down to the vault! Step on the platform!
Hey!
Ma'am, I need to operate the...
All right.
Almost there! Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
He just slept through all that? Oh. Oh man, are we gonna be okay? That first wave that hits us, is that like radioactive stuff already? Is that gonna mess us up? We've been exposed, right?
We did it. We made it.
Hey.
We're okay.
That was a nuke.
Everyone please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion. No need to worry, folks.
Where?
We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
Overseer. After the experiences with the Overseer in Fallout 3, this makes me a little nervous.
Hey.
Just head up the stairs. We'll take care of everything.
Okay. Come on.
Hey, hon.
Now,
it's gonna be okay.
Everyone, just head up these stairs.
Yeah, stick with me, please. Oh.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Levels are good.
What are you guys doing here?
Oh.
Here you are. Head down the hall.
We'll just cut in line.
We'll need your suits before we can take you further. Thanks. What now?
Just
he'll show you where to go.
All right, you three.
Follow me.
Okay.
Follow me.
This is our new home.
All right, let's go.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father died.
Excuse me.
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Okay.
Just checking. The vault suit was designed to be fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Hey there.
Hey there, Mr. Callahan. All right. So,
just
what now?
Step in here and put your vault. It'll be
what?
Okay.
Change in there?
He's right here. See?
Yeah, it's all right.
Who is my little guy, huh? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
Okay. Excuse me, Mr. Russell. Yeah, I'm right here. All right.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Depressurize, huh?
Secure. Occupant vitals. Normal.
All right.
Procedure complete. In five.
This is depressurizing? Okay. Cryogenic stasis. What's going on here?
This is the one. Here.
What are you doing with my husband? Okay. Hey, no, get your hands off my baby.
I got let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once. I'm not giving you.
Who are these people? Hey. What do you mean backup? Hey! So they just unfroze me long enough so I could see him steal my baby and kill my husband? So how long ago was that? How long ago was any of this? We've been frozen.
Come on. There has to be a release.
Okay,
come on,
open
come
up.
Come on. Oh, God.
Oh, it's not looking good. Oh, Nate.
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Oh, boy. Okay. Oh, what else we got?
Why would Vault-Tec do this?
Cryopod manual release override.
That's an excellent question. Oh, that's when I was in. What about... No?
I can't be the only one left.
Hello? Cryopod
anyone?
Hey, quiet. You don't know who's going to be in here with you. You don't want to draw the wrong sort of attention. Although... How did we get out? All right, let's see what we got here. Cryogenic array. Offline. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated manual and remote overrides detected. Controls disabled. Life support? Offline, premature. Okay, so same thing. Pod occupant status. Empty. So that was mine, maybe? No, I'm down there. So who was it? Okay, so someone got out of one, I'm assuming. Mrs. Callahan, deceased. Asphyxiation due to life support failure. Alright. Mr. Callahan? Well, the same. Let's check them all. Mr. Abel? Yep. Mrs. Abel. Nate and Sean? Kidnapped and shot. Unknown, huh? We saw what happened. Oh, my status shows unknown. Override engaged. Well, who engaged the override? Mr. Russell. Alright. Oh, I don't want a screwdriver. Why did I take that? Drop it in a minute. Okay, I don't want to go that way just yet. Let's see what else we can find. Oh, rad roach. Ooh, yeah. Excellent. Oh, now this is interesting. I don't have to actually click on them. It'll tell me what they've got in them. Cool. All right, let's look at this. Okay, security instructions, yes. Confidential. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. What? Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. They froze us for study. How long were they planning on keeping us frozen? Okay, operations protocol manual. Sure, resident admittance. Upon activation notice from Vault-Tec, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the Vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents should not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Okay. Staff duties? Okay, science. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. So they can let up to 80% of us die and not worry about it? Independent research is encouraged and left to overseer discretion. Okay, security. Security patrols are to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer, enforcement of regulations set forth by Vault-Tec. Okay, and facility services and maintenance. Due to the nature of Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these roles is left to overseer discretion. Alright, and all clear and evacuation. All clear?
Following a nuclear event, Vault-Tec will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, Vault-Tec personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault-Tec, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault-Tec will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. And mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault-Tec, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstance may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault-Tec. So there was something. Extermination is everyone's job. So there was something very suspicious going on here. Oh, and I nearly missed a stimpak. Okay. What do we got through here? Oh, I see ya. Okay. Hiya! Haha, take that.
Giant roaches?
Yep.
What the hell?
Ooh, some nice beer bottles. I imagine they're empty. Recreation terminal. Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Well. Top 10. Play tape. Oh. Ooh, 2075, and this is the highest quality game they've got, and this is looking rather like old school Donkey Kong. How high can you get? Oops, not very high apparently. All right, I don't want to eject holotape, huh? Yes, we will quit playing. That's fine. Okay. Now we've got it. Alright. Warning, alarm indicates ammonia has been detected. Leave room immediately. Do not enter without hazmat protection. Alright, what else we got in here? Hot plate. Really scummy bathroom. That's nice. Cleanliness is godliness. Well, we're not very godly here. Well, live well. Lifter hydraulic pressure regulator. Warning, adjusting pressure while doors raised may cause upper door to fall. Well, it looks like this is all pretty well picked through. Lift to access. That doesn't look like I can, though. Alright. What's over here? Fried roach, that's nice. Come here. Oh my gosh, I totally missed it a bunch. That's terrible. There we go. I am not taking rad roach meat. That's gross. Ooh. This guy's been dead a while.
Where is everyone?
There we go. Have a drink.
Oh, hey. Yes, I will take all of those. Pre-war money. Bobby pin. I would like that, yeah.
Is this all that's left?
Okay, what does it say? Select favorite item. And then select. Where is. Yeah, I want my baton. Oh, Overseer's terminal. What do we got? Overseer eyes only. Is this the one that we saw before? Your staff will be on short-term assignment to monitor basic cardiopulmonary and cognitive functions. Long-term monitoring will be handled remotely by Vault-Tec technicians. Under no circumstances is this to be disrupted. Okay, yep. And insubordination or attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Oh, that's good to know. All right, cryolator? I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable, on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. All right, operations protocol manual? Oh, we already saw all this, right? All personnel are required to report, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, we saw this. Overseer's log. Preparations. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault-Tec supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time, I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. Well, you could have got, you know, volunteers for this thing. Like, I don't know. If we hadn't been tricked into being frozen, we would have died in the nuclear blast, so... I mean, I guess I can't complain too much, but still. October 23rd. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. Ah, my family, eh? I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people. It's kind of a crappy thing for you to prey upon. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Okay, systems malfunction. Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override system may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Supplies running low? There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Mutiny. Oh, didn't keep it under control, did ya? A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I'm too damn generous with the rations. People don't like it? Well, that's fewer mouths to feed. Well, sounds like everything went just well. Okay. Open the tunnel. Okay. Personnel evacuation tunnel is now open. Remind all staff to be orderly and follow shutdown protocols before exiting and resealing Vault 111. Please maintain all staff records and research. Report your local Vault-Tec superiors for debriefing and further instruction. Ooh. Alright, there's that. Oh, what have we got here? This must be his bedroom. Preserved cigarettes. Who knows? Maybe they'll be useful. Probably not, but... Alright. Another scummy bathroom. Nothing in his dresser. Ooh, cryolator case.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Yeah, we'll have to remember that thing. All right. A whole bunch of you, eh? There we go. Take that. Oh, what'd they say? Left bumper? Nice. Oh, he figured it out. Oh, more dead guys.
Did anyone get out?
Oh, this is the that other door, isn't it? Because here's that toolbox that we saw at the beginning. Okay, so full circle there. Oh, I'll take that.
Everyone's dead.
They are, but I mean, do you really feel that bad about a bunch of people who deceived you being dead? Huh?
Good boy interface required to activate vault door cycling sequence. Have a nice day.
Oh, well, look at this. Rather handy. A Pip-Boy right here. Put her on. Yeah, let that bone get out of there. Look at this. This is a nice improvement over what we saw in the opening scene there. Not nearly as gigantic. No holotape found. Well, I happen to have one in my inventory, though. Hey there, Pip buddy. Okay. Stimpak, right away, perk chart. Collector. Toughness. Okay. Next rank. Oh wait, did I just spend some points without thinking about it? Or is it saying that's how much perception training? How is this working? Okay, what else have we got? Oh, there's our inventory, security baton. Oh, the other wedding ring. There's the red menace. Okay, I don't steal two and wood. Plastic cloth is bad. Okay, so maybe I can get some stuff out of that. Okay. Quest, out of time. Handy dandy map. Nothing on the radio. Oh, there we go. All right. right, excellent. And I'm actually going to go ahead and wind the episode down here. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this. Come back next time. We'll head out into the world and see how town is looking nowadays.